How do you deal with pressure? In today's video, we cover a pretty common interview question that's also pretty critical, because if you're asked this question in an interview, it probably means your job is going to be stressful, or at least have periods of time that are stressful. And they want to know how you're going to deal with it. In today's video, I'm going to teach you exactly what you need to do to not just pass this interview question, but absolutely crush it. Let's go. Hi everybody, my name is Ben White with Ben Talks Talent. I've got 12 years experience in interviewing, hiring, and recruiting, and I'm passionate about using my experience to help you become the best candidate possible and land your next job. In today's video, we're gonna do another entry into the series of interview questions and answers and showing you how to answer commonly asked interview questions, specifically, how do you deal with pressure? But before we get into the content of the video, do me a favor, if you are new here, take 3 seconds, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and hit that notification bell. That way you never miss one of my free videos that are all designed to help you. And if you are not new, well, hey, it's you again. Welcome back. You look great. Great to see you. Let's get into the video. As always, I want to talk about why. Why would this question be asked in an interview? What is the point? Why would they be asking this to you? So first, I call this a qualifier question, because a qualified person is going to have a good answer to this question, probably because they're going to be dealing with pressure or there's going to be stress in the job. And what they want to know is that you're able to effectively navigate those situations. So if they are asking, it is important because it's probably going to be something you need to deal with on a relatively frequent basis. So how do you answer? First, I actually want to talk about how you don't answer, because there's a few ways you can get this wrong. Now, the first one is don't answer it as if you're the perfect candidate who never gets stressed. If they ask you the question and go, hey Ben, how do you deal with pressure? And you go, I never feel pressure. I am never stressed. I am completely immune to the stresses of modern day life. How believable does that sound? To me, it does not sound believable. Now, the second way that you don't want to answer this interview question is by saying you are the type of person who caves to pressure. Imagine them saying to you, Ben, how do you deal with pressure? And you answer by saying, well, typically what I do is I shy away in the moment, commit mistakes, and run from the pressure and try to avoid it. That sounds terrible. Now, these are two opposite ends of the spectrum. They are the extremes. And with this interview question, you don't want to be an extreme. You want to be in the middle. So let's talk about how you do answer this interview question well. Now, the thing that you want to start by doing is having a mechanism to deal with the stress. I think it's really important. A lot of people will fall back on, I meditate daily so that I am in a good mental space to deal with the stresses of the day. Or at the end of the day, I do a 10-minute meditation session, and no matter how stressful the day was, I'm able to center myself and move forward and be ready for it again. Some people say that they like to exercise. Well, whenever I have a stressful day, what I like to do is I like to tie up my running shoes and hit the pavement. I found that running 4 or 5 miles at the end of the stressful day completely melted away for me. Now, these are really good examples. And if you're going to use this, I think that's great. However, don't forget to include working examples, because part of what they're looking for here is not that you won't be overwhelmed with stress. It is important that the stress won't completely overwhelm you and derail you and make it so you're not able to do this job long term, but they also want to know that you'll be effective in the moment. Now, as far as sharing with them your actual work strategy for answering this question, there's a lot of ways you can go. So there's examples like, well, I'm really good at making lists. Whenever I feel there is a stressful situation, what I do is I make a list, I prioritize the things at the top and the things that absolutely have to get done, and I work my way from top to bottom. And I feel like being organized and being strategic and then one by one, efficiently moving my way through the tasks I need to complete, that helps me deal with stressful situations quite well. That's a great example. Another example might be proactive communication. So maybe you say to them, you know, I think one of the things that you can do to mitigate stress is by actively communicating the situation to the people who are waiting on the work to be done. I've been in several situations in which there was tasks that were piling up, deadlines fast approaching. What you don't want to do is you don't want to communicate that to people so they have unrealistic expectations of your deliverables. Upfront communication is key to dealing with stressful situations. Another really good example. So either one of those is a great way to answer this question in terms of how you're dealing with it in the moment. Now, the key, the absolute key to crushing this interview question is to not just do A or B, but it's to have a solid start and then bring home your answer by giving them an example of a time in the past where you dealt with a situation and you use this strategy to handle it effectively. So I'm gonna answer as if I was a candidate for a recruiting, let's just say a vice president of recruiting, right? Let's just say I personally am interviewing for that. How would I do that? So the person says to me, Ben, how do you deal with stress? And I would say, well, the way I deal with stress in my day-to-day life when I'm working is I make a list. I find that whenever I have a lot of tasks and competing tasks, that it is easy to look at everything and get a bit overwhelmed, but you can immediately solve some of that for yourself if you just make a list, prioritize things, and go through effectively and checking each one off and accomplishing these tasks. I'm also really big on proactive communication, because if people are waiting for you to get done with your deliverables, but they don't know when it's coming or when they can anticipate results, they are going to start to get anxious, and that is going to make you more nervous and compound the stress you're feeling. For example, in my day-to-day life currently and in my current role, I deal with a lot of stress because I'm responsible for a lot of things. I had two clients who are big clients of mine who are waiting for certain results, and the pressure was mounting and the deadline was fast approaching. So what I did was I prioritized the different things I needed to do. I reached out to my team and made sure I allocated the responsibility so we were able to move through and move towards the goal effectively. And then I reached out to both clients and I let them know that while we were dealing with some challenges, I'm absolutely aware of their situation. It's important to me, and I'm working to resolve the issue. So that's how I deal with stress. It is fairly common to me in my role, but I feel like if you have a good system, you can deal with it quite effectively and quite well. And that's a good example of how you can answer this question. If you see what I did there, I stated my system for dealing with it. I let them know that I've dealt with in the past and successfully. And one of the things I did that was part of the language to answering this question, as I said, it is something that is quite common in my role. And I said it calmly, and I said it like a person who believes they are ready to handle the situation. No matter how stressful it is, they're going to come up with a system and they're going to operate effectively. And that is what they are trying to get from you when they ask you this interview question. I hope that answers your question. I hope that helps for your next interview. Good luck in your next interview. You got this.